From finding your father after 28 years into how to keep your marriage healthy, very healthy. We're joined now by sexologist Gertrude Munga. It's good to have you back into the studio, Gertrude.
Thank you, Jimmy, for having me again.
Gertrude has come up with a video. It's called The Modern Sexy Woman. It basically is a way to stay sexy in a marriage or to keep your marriage sexy and exciting. So, Gertrude, before we talk about the DVD, let's talk about your work so far.
Mm-hmm.
When you were here last time, a lot of SMSs, a lot of emails, people saying, finally, somebody who can speak the truth about what happens in a marriage.
I remember.
How has your experience been, and who do you get a lot of accolades from? Because I tend to think you speak more for the man than the woman.
No, actually, it's more for the woman. Okay, the man benefits, but it's more for the woman. Okay, because most of the time, many women think when you get married, marriage is not fun anymore.
Right.
And your life becomes boring. I beg to differ. You know, you can be excited and enjoy your life to the fullest as a married woman.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, but then the man benefits.
Right.
Okay, can you imagine having all these things with your wife? You don't need mpango ya kando, as you say.
When you say all these things, what exactly do you mean? What is wrong with our marriages? And why the need then to do what you do and do it well, almost to a career?
Mm-hmm.
I think it is a career.
It is a career.
And of course, come up with a DVD that, of course, continues.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, this gives you a lifeless sort of stature.
This is everything I've been doing for the last 7 years. What I've been teaching women for the last 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? The major thing here is for the woman to be a one-stop shop. Anybody who's attended my sessions, they know that's what I preach.
Uh-huh.
You have to be a one-stop shop. You have to be a good wife, which so many women do as married women. You have to be a good lover. Not so many of us do that. And you have to take it a notch higher. You have to be a nice little whore to your husband.
I see.
Exactly.
And so, a good mother. Yeah, you said mother as well.
Yes.
Exactly. The reason why I asked you the first question is you go against the grain in terms of and I like what you said in your preface at the back of this DVD.
Mm-hmm.
And so powerful. We socialize girls that sex is all bad and very bad when they're young.
True.
Then when we're betrothing them, we say it's a beautiful thing, it was created by God, enjoy yourself.
And nobody tells you how to do this. Okay, so your mind is supposed to switch sex is bad and then sex is good. It doesn't work that way. Okay, it's okay. When they're young, of course, they're not supposed to indulge in sex.
Right.
But then when they're getting married, can we at least take the time to prepare them for the bedroom, especially? Because by then you've gone to school, you know, to go about finances.
Yes.
You know, and you've seen a few beauticians, so you know how to look
to
beautiful.
Look, that's right.
But then nobody tells you anything about sex.
I see what you mean.
And that's one of the most important things in a marriage.
So what are you saying? That for men, we've got stag parties, which...
Which most of them are not very good.
Yes. Who says who, anyway? Then for women, you've got showers.
Yes.
Which most of them are not good.
If I do the showers, they are the best.
So what is lacking then in those two institutions that are meant to prepare somebody into marriage?
The stag parties and showers?
Yeah, exactly. For stag, it's meant to be, you know, our boy is going down, so let's send him off nicely, you know, say goodbye to single.
Oh, let's have fun
the last time.
Okay, and that's not supposed to happen. You see, for the bridal showers, and the reason why I started giving talks in the first place, I was catering for a bridal shower, and the few married women who were there had nothing good to say about marriage. I could see the bride really freaking out. Okay, they were all full of negative. Your life is going to end. You're going to add a lot of weight. You know, he's going to continue seeing his ex-girlfriends, and you're just going to be there in the house, which is not the truth. Okay, because if life was that bad, why were they still married?
Exactly.
There
are
bad things, which is normal. Fights are there, and so many disagreements. But then there are also very, very good and beautiful things in marriages.
Absolutely.
So I started talking to her, the bride, about the positive. You know, how she can actually enjoy, make a bad situation work for her. Okay, and she needs to hang in there. A lot of patience and prayers, she should be able to enjoy her life to the fullest.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Tell us about the experiences you've had in showers. What sort of response do you get, especially from women who, as you've said, I mean, they only know the negative side of marriages, and perhaps not very quick to say, I really don't know how to work this. I don't want to say, because if I do, I look kind of inexperienced. Do you get that kind of response, and how do you...
A lot of women are resentive. Jimmy, it's so funny. Some married women don't even like their husbands.
Oops.
Yeah. So we are not even talking about love here. They don't even like them. So a lot of women think it's too much responsibility to a woman. Why should I have to be the only one, the one to do this and do this? And he's not doing anything. He's not trying to meet me halfway. And that's why I started couple sessions. Right. And these days I also talk to men. Because after having a shower with me, you learn so many things. You know how to go about so many different things. Okay. And then what happens to the man? Okay, exactly. Most men don't even try to meet the women halfway.
So have you ever talked in a stag party?
Yes,
and
I have.
Is it different, very different from a shower?
It is different. The angle is different. But I came to realize both men and women want the same thing. You know, we all want the same thing. We all want to go to Mombasa, but the men prefer to fly. We love the bus or the train. Yeah, we want the same thing. Okay, absolutely. We have almost the same insecurities. Okay, we are not sure whether this is the right way. So if you work on communication, most of the time things work out.
We'll come to two other topics that you've discussed, which is very different. And I like the fact that you talk about them. Mm-hmm. I wonder why, but it's good. We'll talk about them shortly. But before we wind up on this one, in terms of, do men say, yes, I want a person who's a one-stop shop. I want a wife, I want a mother, and I want, like you said, a whore. Can't believe I just said that. Yeah.
This is tricky, and I know it's going to put me in a lot of trouble. Actually, funny enough, men have been having their cake and eating it. And
are you sure just men alone?
Yes,
are you sure?
Yes,
I'm not very sure about that.
Okay.
Women have been given the opportunity to be able to you know, because the society protects women. And I know I'll get into a lot of trouble for this, but it's true.
But men are allowed to get away so much.
If you go to marriage counseling sessions, it's always about how to protect yourself from the man, which I think is a huge problem.
It is a huge problem.
Absolutely. But anyway, you were saying.
I'm saying most men are comfortable with having a wife good for presentation in the home. You understand? Good enough for guys to check her out, you know, for your mom to be proud of. Okay? And they want to have their lovers out there. And they're okay going to the streets and strip joints. You see, this hurt us as women, okay? So this DVD equips the woman to be that good wife for presentation.
I see.
And to be that good lover, to have fun, you know, and go out. And to be that nice little hoe, working it on the pole.
Absolutely.
If you like, okay? But it's not...
And do men say, yeah, thank you very much for introducing my wife to this, you know, finally. I want to tell her.
They're excited.
But somebody else, are they excited?
They're excited. But this is more for the woman to make sure you keep your man home. Show your man you can be the three in one.
I see.
Okay, what men don't realize, they also need to be three in one to the woman.
Okay, explain.
That's what they don't realize.
Explain.
Okay, you know, even a man has to be a one-stop shop. Okay,
because a good husband, a good father.
Yeah, so in the trainings, you know, you're supposed to have three men. Okay, but you can get the three men in one.
Okay.
One with a big fat wallet to buy you whatever you want. Okay, the one you love with all your heart, and the other
sweet
one,
sweet guy, you only pick him in the mouth.
And the other one who can make you dance and sing in your mother tongue in the bedroom.
I see.
So most of the time I ask guys, who are you? The one with the big fat wallet, the one I love with my heart, or the one who can really make me sing in my mother tongue in the bedroom? So it's the same thing, you know, it's the same thing. If you can only try, you know, marriage is a commitment, Jimmy.
Yes, it is. Yes,
okay,
it is.
There's so many other people.
That's true.
But this is a commitment. I've committed to you. Can you at least commit to me, or at least meet me halfway? It's important.